Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Chapter some basic principles and techniques in organic chemistry, and we are doing the topic resonance effect and the phenomenon of resonance. Hello friends, now we are going to talk about what is actually resonance and what are the phenomena of the resonance. By taking an example, we are going to discuss about that. So this is the thing that we have discussed, and we are going to discuss in the future things also, like the resonance of benzene and all. So let us start with a short example that what is actually resonance and what is the resonance phenomenon. So let us talk about it. So now, before understanding what is resonance, it is very essential for us to understand that what is the definition of the resonance. So as we see, that is the phenomenon in which the compounds exist in a state which is combination of two or more electronic structures, and each of which seems equally capable of describing most of the property of the compound, but none of them describes all the property of the compound. And that kind of phenomenon that has been showcased by a particular compound is known as the resonance. So let me give a short example from which we could understand what is actually resonance. So I'll give you a short example, and I'll give you the detail that the resonance effects are shown by which kind of molecules. So suppose this is a carboxylic acid that we have, and suppose on dissociation what will occur is we'll get two types of that species, and those are basically R C double bond O minus, that is the one which has negative charge, while the other one will having H plus, which is nothing but a proton. So therefore in this case basically the deprotonation has occurred, and from which we have got to a carboxylate ion, that is this one, and a proton, that is this one. So in this case we are concerned with the carboxylate ion. The reason behind that is it consists of pi electrons, and moreover we could see that it consists of lone pair of electrons that are also been located in both of the oxygen. So I am concerned about this thing. So to understand resonance and the resonating structure that are been involved in that case, so it is very essential for us to know that is resonance are the one that are been showcased by basically the molecules that have pi bonds, and the delocalization of electrons that would take place so as to form the resonating structures, and this is what I am going to talk about. So the carboxylate ion that we are talking about is can be written this way, that is, and in which the oxygen, one of the oxygen consists of a negative charge, or we could say that the pi electron. The reason behind that is, as you could see over here, that this OH, if I am talking about this one, so this OH has been converted into H plus. The reason behind that is the electron of the hydrogen has been approached by the oxygen, making the hydrogen to acquire a positive charge while the oxygen to acquire the negative charge. So that is the reason that this oxygen acquires two electrons, and the both these two electrons will form a negative charge that could be written as in this way also, as you could see over here. So this is the negative charge, and again this negative charge can be written as with a lone pair of electrons that you could see here. So now this is what makes us to understand the resonance effect, and that's the reason that we could write it in this way, where this oxygen consists of the lone pair of electron that we usually know. So this is the lone pair of electron, and meanwhile talking about the negative charge, and this is the negative charge, and again that consists of two electrons, as you could see. So now the shifting of electrons, or we could say the delocalization of electron, would take place in such a manner that this two electron, as you could see over here, it will be shifted to this bond, that is between the carbon and oxygen, as you could see in this case. And if that happens, then what we could see is the carbon, which is now basically the one which has four bonds, or it, we could call it as a tetravalent, and because of the bond formation would happen, if the bond formation would happen because of this two electrons, so now this would be a pentavalent, but a pentavalent carbon atom is very much unstable. So that's the reason that this two electrons, as you could see here, even they would be shifted on the oxygen atom, and since oxygen atom can acquire this two electrons because oxygen is the one which is more electronegative, in this case we could see that the structure is now been converted into this form, as I am writing over here, that is R C O And because of here, as you could see, the double bond has been formed. So therefore, this is a double bond that would be formed over here. While this oxygen, which consists of lone pair of electrons, but no need to mention over there, but as we could see that this two electrons has been approached on this oxygen. So making this oxygen to have a negative charge, or we could write it over as this two electrons, making this to be negative. And even this was the one which is negative. And meanwhile, talking about the lone pair of electrons that were already present, that was being indicated by the red dot, and that is as it is here also. So these are the two structures that we are observing, and in this case, because these are the two resonating structures, because these are the structures that are following the resonance, and that is the reason that to differentiate it, or so as to convert from one form to another form, we have represented with an arrow, a double headed arrow over here, as you could see over here. So that indicates that this is the resonating structure. These are the two other resonating structures. And talking about this one, that according to the definition, we have got to know that none of the structure would be will give the full information or the full properties of the overall compound. So that is the reason this two, among this one, if I take this one, so this won't give the overall property of the compound. Neither this resonating structure will give the overall property of the compound. So that is the reason that there should be a structure which is more stable, as well as which will have a capability to give overall property of a compound, and that is known as resonance hybrid. I'll talk about these two structures. These two structures are known as resonating structures. So the delocalization, the delocalized electron, or we could say the electrons that are shifting, so therefore in this case I have represented it with a blue dot. So these are the electrons that are shifting from one bond to another bond, and that is the reason that they are known as delocalized electron, or they move on, or they are not placed in a one position only, they move, and that is the reason they are delocalized electron. And because of the delocalized electron only, we could see the resonance effect or the resonance. And talking about the next one, if you observe that the atoms that were in their own position, they are not being changed, so they are remaining as it is. The only thing that is been changing is the position of the delocalized electron, and that makes us to understand that this is a resonance effect. And so this both the structures are not that much stable, so that's the reason we are approaching towards a new structure which will be more stable, and that is the reason that I'm drawing the structure over here in this case like this one. So because of the delocalization of electron, we can't predict that the electron is present in a particular oxygen, because in carboxylic acid we have mentioned two oxygen atoms over here. So that's the reason we are making it with a dotted lines, as you could see here. So this dotted line indicates that the electrons are not in one place, they are shifting or they are moving or delocalizing. And this is the structure that we have drawn. It is basically known as hybrid structure or resonance hybrid. So this is the structure that we have. And meanwhile, in both the cases, as you have saw that the negative charges on either of the oxygen, so that's the reason this is a complete oxygen which has a complete negative charge, while this one is neutral, while even this is a negative charge while the other one is neutral. But talking about the resonance hybrid, in this case the electron will be distributed, because the electron are be shifting from one oxygen to other oxygen, as you could see, and that's the reason that this oxygen will acquire minus half charge, and again this oxygen will acquire minus half charge. So this is what we have got to know. And talking about the stability, as I've mentioned again, that this resonance hybrid will be more stable and compared to that of the resonating structure. And the reason behind that is, it is not only because we could say that this is the stable structure because it has formed, there is no, we can't predict whether where the delocalized electron is, and that is the reason it is being more stable. But talking about the more if I talk about an effective approach to understand that why this is more stable, so we have to know resonance energy and what is actually resonance energy. So therefore there is a next approach that we are going to talk about, and that is resonance energy. And what is actually resonance energy? So because resonance hybrid that we have and resonating structure that we have, so that is resonating energy that we are going to talk about. It is nothing but the difference between these two energy levels, that is the one which is resonance hybrid and the one which is a resonating structure. So that difference between these two energy is basically known as resonance energy. And talking about this thing, it has been found that this hybrid structure of the carboxylate is very much stable, and the lower the energy, then we could say that more the stable it is, more the stable the compound it is. So therefore, this resonating structure is more stable compared to that of the other structures, and that's the reason that it is stable. And we could say that the difference between the resonating structure, it will go on increasing, or the resonating energy, it will be very much less if we find that more the number of resonating structures are occurred because of a particular compound, like for benzene. So in benzene also the resonating structure occurs, and that's the reason that we could get multiple resonating structures of that, and that's the reason that we could say that the benzene is more stable compared to that of the carboxylate ion. So that is what I wanted to talk about. And let me give you another information, that the resonance or the shifting or delocalization of electron takes place for p electrons only, for p orbitals. That is, even this carbon is the one which has p orbital, because the talking about the electronic configuration of carbon, it is I would write over here just to explain. That is, it is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2, making this to have basically p orbitals. That is, one is px and py, and the next one is pz. But talking about the oxygen atom, even oxygen atom can be written in this way. That is 1s2, 2s2, 2p4. So if I talk about this one, then even this will have p electrons or p orbitals that you could see that acquires an electron. So that's the reason that these two atoms, they should be very close to each other, so as to we could say that the shifting of pi electrons would take place, and that's the reason that the shifting of pi bond would also take place, and that's the reason that resonance effect would be observed. And that is what I wanted to approach with this theory. And I hope you have understood that what is actually resonance, and what are the structures that are being involved, and what is the phenomenon due to which the resonance effect has been observed. So yes, we have also got to know that what is resonance hybrid and the stability of it. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you have understood that what is resonance, and this resonance concept, it will be very much influential in studying the aromatic compound or the resonating effect that has been showcased by the benzene or any kind of aromatic compound. So thank you friends for watching this video. I hope you will share this video with your friends, and just don't forget to subscribe to Ekeeda channel. Thank you so much.